Think about money. Think about your financial life. Oh yes, this is lovely. Think about your finances. Okay, now, start to be kind to your finances. Start to be kind. So think about every time you've looked at your bank account and you've gone, fuck, shit, I hate this, or that's not enough, or whatever, okay? Apologize. To your bank account, apologize to money. Now apologize to you, okay? Now, start to invite, seduce, demand, and request that more money than you know how to handle avalanches into your lives immediately. And everything that doesn't allow that, straight okay. Right and wrong, good and bad, all nine, pud, puck, shirts, boys and hands. Now I guarantee you, many of you will find money. All of a sudden be in your bank account, you don't know where it came from, or you'll be walking down the street and you'll find money, or somebody will just give you money, okay? I guarantee you, all of you guys, by the next time we have class, some of you will be like, yeah, so I got this money, okay? Now, are you guys open to having money come to you from all sources and everywhere, or have you already concluded, decided, and judged that it can only come through specific sources? Okay, so all of the restrictions that you've put on to where money can come from in your lives, will you destroy and uncreate it, please? Right and wrong, good and bad, all nine, pud, puck, shirts, boys, meons. Okay, so you want money to be able to come from all directions, from everything, everyone, and everything. And everything that doesn't allow that, destroy and uncreate it. Right and wrong, good and bad, all nine, pud, puck, shirts, boys, meons. Because what if money could come to you in ways that you cannot even determine? Okay?
I'm getting stuck on the avalanche.
I'm getting stuck on the avalanche. Now, did I use that word?
Burying me.
Yes. What a terrible thing to be buried by money.
Yeah.
So everywhere that you could not bear the weight of money, will you destroy and uncreate it, please? Right and wrong, good and bad, all nine, pod, puck, shirts, boys, and everywhere you were buried for your money, will you destroy and uncreate all this? Right and wrong, good and bad, all nine, pud, puck, shirts, boys, meons. And all of the wealth that you were buried with that you cannot find, will you destroy and uncreate everything that doesn't allow you to come to you now with ease? Right and wrong, good and bad, all nine, pud, puck, shirts, boys, meons. And everywhere you're unwilling to be overwhelmed by having too much money, will you destroy and uncreate all that? Right and wrong, good and bad, all nine, pud, puck, shirts, boys, meons. Do you guys know... It's like, what's easier to handle? Not a lot of money or too much money? Okay, so there's you guys know Robert Kawasaki?
Yeah.
He wrote Rich Dad Poor Dad. He wrote this other book, I think Increasing Your Financial IQ. And I was reading it at one point, and he talks about how there's problems with having no money and problems with having money. Because when you have money, you also have to figure out what to do with it so the government doesn't take it or so the banditos don't come and rob. You know, it's like having money. So all the lifetimes that you guys were killed for your money, it was all stolen from you, you know, there was big wars and you lost everything. Everything that you decided in other lifetimes about money that you never wanted to go through again, that's preventing that amount of money from ever showing up in your life again, wow. Will you destroy and uncreate it, please?
Yes.
Right and wrong, good and bad, all nine, pud, puck, shirts, boys, and girls.